There's one problem. He still has one bag of mulch left. He can't believe it. This has never happened before. Well, the extra bag of mulch drives him crazy. He's the guy who always gets the right amount of mulch. So, on the drive home, he throws the bag of mulch out the window over the side of the 101.
And?
Well, that's it. He throws it out the window.
That's the punchline?
That's kind of a thinker.
I'll say. Makes me think you forgot the rest of the joke.
Bojack Horseman is a rare blip on the radar of pop culture. It's a show that explores happiness, depression, and the complexity of trying to be yourself and trying to be happy. The titular Bojack Horseman fights through depression, alcoholism, and love, but the show always comes back to his sense of identity. The central themes evolve from Bojack's search for what makes him happy and why he's become so miserable. One of the hardest things for Bojack is to resist forming his identity from those around him. He can't let go of Princess Carolyn because she defines his working life. He can't let go of Todd because he defines Bojack's conscience. He can't let go of Diane because she defines his ability to love. He can't embrace Mr. Peanut Butter because rejecting him defines Bojack's sense of other. And I want to focus on this moment to demonstrate my point.
It's a dark moment.
You got it.
Scene 22 Alpha, take one.
Action!
Hey, Secretary.
What are you doing here?
Bojack has finally achieved his dream to play Secretariat in a biopic. It's the one thing he thought would make him happy ever since his childhood. And after a deep loss, Bojack finds a new sense of purpose and becomes cheerful, enjoying his life as best he can. It's one of the first honest expressions of hope in the show after a whole season of progressive complication. And this moment coincides with Bojack landing his big dream role.
I just can't wait to tackle it head on.
In any other show, Bojack would enter the new season with his renewed attitude, and a tragedy would befall him. Someone in the hospital dies, a building blows up, a serial killer isn't convicted. We all know how serialized drama hits the reset button after a great revelation. Instead of showing us a dramatic twist, the showrunners opt for a more subtle approach. Bojack's new attitude clashes with his role as Secretariat.
Just use this time to regroup, really figure out what we are doing, why we're here.
In the episode, which forms the inciting hook for the season, the turning point occurs when Bojack realizes he can't have it both ways. He can't be happy and play the one role that suits his addiction to destruction. This reflects the show's largest and most powerful theme, and one that mirrors the realities of life in a brutal way that other shows would take 7 or 8 seasons to deliver. Even when you think things will be better, even when you think you've finally arrived at the job, or the relationship, or the situation where things will get better, they don't. They never are. Things get worse. Things always get worse. We all try our hardest, and everyone does bad things, and everyone does good things. And one of the biggest questions Bojack Horseman asks its audience is this: if we were more of the things we wanted, would it actually make us happy? And Bojack wonders if landing his dream role will make him happy. And in the end, his happiness sabotages his dream role. I don't really have a dramatic point to close with. I usually do. I try and write something. So I'll just say this instead. If a show about a cartoon horse can evoke questions about the nature of happiness and the inevitability of truth, chances are at least one of your ideas are valid. So go make something and give it time. It might just pay off.
You come by it honestly, the ugliness inside you.
You were born broken. That's your birthright.
And now you can fill your life with projects, your books and your movies and your little girlfriends, but it won't make you whole.
Thanks to Daniel Larson, who composes the music for these, did a brilliant job covering the Bojack Horseman theme. Big thanks to our Patreons, and thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments what you think of Bojack Horseman. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss another episode, and as always, I'll see you guys next time.